In the midnight moonlight, and every time I do, I keep seeing this picture of you. Here comes my baby.
So the concept of Butter Negro was born out of a very sincere love for travel and a desire to connect the city's people, places, and cultures in a more authentic, intimate way. And while we can all go online and kind of book our own flights and book our own hotels, and we can pool our own social networks to find all the in-the-know restaurants and bars and lounges, what Butter Negro is trying to do is to take you offline and to connect with real people in real places in the cities that we love, targeting well-traveled, culturally savvy fellow foodies such as yourself. Butter Negro is a new travel-inspired membership program that's going to be bringing travelers and locals alike together in intimate dining and cultural experiences.
And they just said that this is the component of the meal that is most authentic, just traditional dim sum, because of course every pork dumpling is shaped like a little pig.
And well, most of the days now when you go to a dim sum restaurant, those are Cantonese. And then the last one is the deep fried dumplings. And we use an emu, a very healthy meat, instead of pork. So, enjoy.
Is this
such
like a pretzel?
It is.
So oh, it's a pretzel.
We nothing alike. I don't think you look anything alike.
Better looking view.
I know. One of the great things that we just experienced here was couples, obviously your brother and his new bride, a lot of my single friends, some of the men about town, all came to Butter and Egg Road today, and they had a very special kind of experience. What has been some of the highlights of curating these, not just the culinary aspect, not the cultural aspect, but seeing people you know and love, and then also strangers who are just new to Butter and Egg Road, ignite, as is one of your power words. How can you describe the highlights of seeing that grow over the past 12 months?
Well, it's been fantastic because it's bringing, Butter Negro in its essence is bringing together locals and travelers alike. And you may not know anyone around the table, but you may see people that you've seen at other venues or other parties or whatnot. But you're seeing them, I think, at this point in a different context because you're here for a purpose of whether it is for a certain culinary phenomenon or a city festival or really deep diving into a neighborhood and really learning about that, mm-hmm. the pulse of that neighborhood. So you're coming around the table, not with a specific agenda, not with, you know, a networking opportunity or to meet your next date, but you're all coming around there to enjoy good food, to meet new people. It's coming from a really honest place.
Mm-hmm. Obviously, one of the interesting things about this concept is that so many people think they may know a city because they've been to New York a million times, but in actuality, they're on the surface of the urban experience. They're not like inside any kind of thing that is tribal or annual or something that's seasonal. Tell us a little bit about New York and what you might have planned there.
Yeah, for sure. So, yes, New York is one of those places that's frequently traveled to by a lot of people. Most people do at least one or two weekend getaways there. What's different about Butter Negro is that we always focus on one specific neighborhood at a time. So you're really having an opportunity to really get to know the people of that neighborhood, the streets, the retailers, the greatest coffee shops within that neighborhood, the restaurants.
Now, a lot of people obviously will dabble into food, and then there are a lot of people who will do Butter and Egg Rogue who are just die-hard food enthusiasts, and they want to marry dining with travel, which I think is a really great opportunity here with the membership, with what you're doing. Now, I know the previews have been really exciting and very hotly, kind of hot ticket in town. Tell me about the top three anecdotes where something unexpected happened, and someone learned something they didn't know about a chef or a restaurant.
Well, the restaurant the experience we just had here was at Le Wahin, and the chef Chan came out, who's one of the most renowned chefs to do dim sum, I think probably in this country, arguably North America, and he put together the most innovative menu for us. And when asked what his favorite dim sum dish was, I was a bit surprised to find out that it's not his lobster dumpling or emu fried dumpling or foie gras dumpling. It's chicken feet.
Exactly. It's great.
And those are the moments that everyone says, you know, just like us.